gets toxified by the chemicals which are poisonous, which makes you withdraw from life. See, the pesticides and all the chemicals, even when they spray on the plants, they cover their mouth. Then when they eat, are you going to cover the mouth? No, when they spray, they cover the mouth. I wanted to ask them, even while you spray, you cover your mouth and nose, then when you eat, are you going to put it through some other hole? Understand, anything which makes your internal organ, intra organ, withdraw from life. Understand, pesticides and chemical fertilizers are the conspiracy against underdeveloped countries, third world. Please understand. Already the third world country, huge chunk, already is toxified, suffering with the side effects of the toxification, including cancer, impotency, and low immunity, many other disorders. I am not even talking about the mental impact, side effects, all the things you go through psychologically. I am talking only about the physical. Mahadeva talks about jati dosha, nimitta dosha, ashraya dosha.
I welcome you all with my love and respects. Today's subject is the secrets of pain and pleasure. Patanjali is the first master who has worked on the secrets of pains and pleasures. Pain is not pain as you understand now, if you understand in a right way. Pleasure is not a pleasure as you understand now, if you understand in a right way. Something is happening in you for no reason. Something is getting responded in you without you responding. That's the most funny thing. Without you directly involving or responding, something is getting responded. So that some response suddenly gets labeled as a pain or pleasure. Why it gets labeled as pain or pleasure, even that you don't know. You know only one thing, pain is there or pleasure is there. It's like a poor guy with no money got into the small restaurant of a motel and simply whatever is served, not even served, put inside the mouth, this guy has to swallow and come out. I really tell you from my experience, without you choosing, pain and pleasure being caused to you is prison. Nothing else is a prison. Understand? Nothing else is a prison. People again and again asked me, Swamiji, you are an incarnation. You should have just walked out of the prison. I never felt that as a prison. Nothing is a prison. The real prison is pain or pleasure happening to you without you choosing, without you deciding, without you voting, without you being asked. The menu cards are never shown to you. Just food is supplied to your table, not even to your table, to your throat. And sometimes it is just pushed inside. And you don't know why it is happening, and you don't know who is doing. Just only in your throat you feel the taste. That's all. Secrets of pains and pleasures. Patanjali is the first master who made human beings as master of their own life, things which happen in their life. We will enter into the today's sutras. Last session we were studying the 12th sutra of second chapter. I wanted to go through that sutra once more. Klesha Moola Karma Asayaha Drishta Adrishta Janma Vedaniya. Swami Satchidananda translates the sutras, the womb of karmas, actions and reactions, has its roots in these obstacles. And the karmas bring experiences in the seen are in the unseen births. The womb of karmas, karmashaya, need to be understood. The word womb of karmas need to be understood. That's a technical term. That's a key word in this whole sutra. I can say for next few sutras, this is the technical term which you need to understand. Womb of karmas. Place where the actions and reactions happen continuously in you, even if you don't interfere. You can say where you experience life in you. It's a very deep level truth. You experience actions in one level, reactions in another one level, but the root cause of both actions and reactions is what we call karmashaya. Please understand, all your actions unreactions, the source from which they erupt, the source from which they happen is called karmashaya. I can say You experience the same karmashaya during the deep sleep state, what we call as causal body, karana sarira. Karmashaya is experienced in karana sarira. Karmashaya is almost like a go down. See how I describe the desire engrams are stored in the prana sarira. Guilt engrams are stored in mana sarira. Pain engrams are stored in sukshma sarira. All the engrams broken, poisonous, can't be worked out in this birth. Too much of joy or too much of suffering. For example, a poor beggar, for him, 100 crore winning in the lottery is too much of suffering. Understand, it's not too much of joy. It's too much of suffering. He will not be able to handle that money. So when he can't handle that money will be the death for him. Naturally, people who want that money, who want to own that money, they won't respect his life. For them, the 100 crore is too big. They'll just take away his life and money. It won't be a big thing. So it is too much suffering for him. So that kind of karmas, which may bring too much suffering or too much joy, all of them will be in the godown. It's almost like all the karmas which you accumulated in all janmas, everything will be in that godown. It's very important to understand the quality of your godown. See, I am not saying you need to know everything in your godown. It's not possible. It's not possible unless you go through a special process. Unless you go into the past birth regression, which may not be required. Which actually may not be required. Maybe just for a taste. Like a levitation. See, this levitation is not really directly required for enlightenment, but an excitement. Everybody tries. Now I see thousands of things I have spoken about enlightenment. Nobody is watching those videos. Everybody is watching these few fellows jumping. And it is flying, clicks thousands. Every day it is increasing at least 1,000 views. It's an excitement. Same way, maybe for excitement reason, you can go through some past life regression. Know the details, where you took birth. Sometimes it is dangerous because the same husband will be now wife for you. Because they need to take revenge. Sometime. But usually it does not happen. Usually 99.9999% the couples just escape and go to the different corners of the world. They take care, even in 2012 they don't meet each other. Even if there is some tsunami or they don't meet each other. They manage. But sometime, unfortunately, rarely, these guys meet. You may not need to know the details of karmashaya, but the flavor of karmashaya, the smell of your godown, you may not need to know what all you put in your godown. Like how many cans of Coca-Cola is there, how many cars are dumped, and how many furnitures are dumped, how many tins of rotten, stinking clothes are lying. How many? You don't need to know all that. But you need to know the general smell of the godown. That is very important, because many of your life's incidents will be flavored, will have the odor of the godown. I have seen people, such an amazing, such great, wonderful happenings will be happening in their life, but the poor fellows will be suffering with that bad odor of the godown. Means not feeling satisfied, suffering. Just some suffering happened some days before or some months before, some years before. Just carrying it and suffering. They don't even know why. Sometimes you can see in yourself, early morning, such a beautiful ambience. Cool breeze. Anandeshwara is there. Just directly below Swamiji is sitting. And Pratyaksha Pada Puja is happening. He is in Samadhi. Best place to be. But some nuisance engrams you would have repeated in your dream, or you would have seen again in the dream, or which happened 5 years before, just suddenly you would have remembered, will be sitting on your head heavily, and will not allow you to enjoy that whole beauty. Even you will hate yourself. What is going on in me? The whole crowd is in bliss. The scene which you can never see. The scene which you can never feel. It is such an ecstasy. Such an joy. But why am I in depression? Just because of one thing. You do not know the order of your godown. Knowing the order of the godown, actually if you know the order of the godown, you will just discount it. You will not, I am not saying hate or like, no. You just know that this is the godown smell, that's all. Nothing else need to be done. When your godown is too dirty, you can just know very clearly, hey, this is the godown smell. It is not anything else. That is enough. Even in your room, in your house, you can see sometime when you enter, you feel, oh God, such a dirty smell, what is going on? But when you know the reason, the moment you know the reason, suddenly you will see that smell is not affecting you anymore. You are able to live with it. You just say, all right, it's okay. Same way, awareness about the smell of the godown takes away much of your suffering. It just removes many sufferings. And here, Patanjali is using an important term. This reaction and action from that karmashaya, godown, happens in the seen and unseen births. Many translators are translating this word unseen as future births. I do not want to translate that word unseen as future. It is future also, but even now you are living an unseen life. Please understand. Even now you are living an unseen life in this very chronological time, without your knowledge, which everybody else knows. Just go around and ask 10 people who are every day living with you opinion about you. You will never believe that opinion. Ask them to give an honest opinion. They don't need to write their name. They can just type it and leave it in your Facebook or in your table. Tell them, do this simple exercise. Tell the people who are living every day with you or who are seeing you at least once in 2-3 days. Some 10-20 people. You can choose your best friends and worst enemies or neutral people, anybody. Just tell them. You write your opinion about me or type. You don't need to put your name. I don't need to know you only wrote that opinion. Just write and give. Collect those 10 opinions and see. You will not be able to believe any of the opinions. But that is the life which you are living as they perceive. Understand, even now, you are living an unseen life. So in that unseen life, many of your karmas, the actions and reactions, are expressing from the karmashaya. One more thing you need to know about the karmashaya is, it's almost like a sleeping Pandora box, sleeping zoo. It's like you enter into a dark room and 2000 poisonous cobras are sleeping and 100 lions are sitting, some 100 dinosaurs are sleeping, and you are supposed to walk through that room and come out other side. That is the way the karmashaya is. You do not know which snake will be awakened at what moment, which dinosaur will be awakened at what moment, which lion will wake up and roar at which moment. But all the fellows are sitting inside. Karmashaya is a very powerful and most dangerous part of you, whose flavor, odor, smell constantly oozes out, constantly oozes out, constantly oozes out in your seen and unseen lives. When Patanjali uses the word unseen lives, he does not mean the future births. He means future births also, even in this birth, the unaware times. Understand? Any moment you spend without awareness, not being aware of your boundary, is unseen life. Understand? The unseen life does not mean only the future birth. Even now, any moment you spend without having the awareness of what is happening in your body and mind is unseen life. All the incidents or the happening moments you spent unseen way gets together, leads to big disease physically or mentally. See, all major sufferings are accumulated slowly, not suddenly. Very slowly it is accumulated. It takes lot of time to accumulate suffering. Please understand, it does not happen just like that. It takes so much time to accumulate suffering. The unseen life is responsible for accumulating suffering. When I see people getting caught in some engrams, I know it is not that it has happened just like that overnight. No. Slowly, 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 slowly only it got acquired. So infusing awareness into your system, be aware of walking, talking, sitting, even now. Sitting is different. I know I am sitting is different. When you are just sitting, you are a matter, dead. When you know you are sitting, you are sat, you are consciousness. Chit or jata, whether you are a chit or jata will be decided, you are a, means, whether you are a matter or consciousness will be decided with these two statements. Are you sitting or do you know you are sitting? If you are sitting, you are jata, matter. If you know you are sitting, you are chit, consciousness. So from morning, calculate the moment. I am really trying to, just 2 days before, I was visualizing exactly which nadi gets activated when you are aware that you are aware. there is a nadi next to kurma nadi. That nadi only gets activated. So I am planning for a meter. If you fix the meter, whenever you are aware of your existence, those moments will be recorded in that meter. So if you just tie a meter around a person's hand like a wristwatch, whole day and night if he walks around, end of the night you can see how much time he spent in awareness and how much he spent in unawareness. We can very clearly calculate the seen life and unseen life. If you have spent 8 hours in awareness, that awareness is seen life. That part is seen life. Means that 8 hours you are a chit, consciousness. If you have spent 8 hours in unconsciousness, unaware way, that 8 hours is jata, unconscious. That is what Patanjali calls as unseen life. I think I'll be successful in creating that meter because I found out exactly which nerve is active, alive, next to kurma nadi. There is a nadi in our system. Now I have to only work with the medical field. When that nadi is active, how to record that nadi? Then we can just have a meter for everybody and we'll know very clearly whether they are able to practice that awareness or not. See, it is simple. If you are sitting, you are matter, dead. If you know you are sitting, you are chit, consciousness. This moment you can be alive and next moment you can be dead. Again, next moment you can be alive. All unaware moments are death. All aware moments are life. Every moment you are aware, your whole mechanism functions in a different way. Not just your mind, which is responsible for cognition. No. Not just your mind, which is responsible for cognition. Even your body, which is responsible for your sensory experiences. Please understand. Even your body, which is responsible for your sensory experiences, acts and reacts in a completely different way the moment you are aware you are sitting or whatever is happening in you. Awareness straight away, without any gap, transforms the cognition process and sensory perceptions. Sensory perceptions means whatever you experience through the body. Cognition process means your reaction to all the happenings through the body. Means whatever goes on in your mind. So understand, it is a very simple process. The problem Patanjali talking in the sutra is too big. The solution is too simple. That is where we suspect Patanjali's motive. How can such big problem be solved with such a small way? Looks too illogical. But what to do? That is the way it is. But our logic is such, it always says, oh, problem is too big. How can this big problem be solved in such small way? It can be. So the 12th sutra talks something very important. The root womb of actions and reactions, where all your karmas, all your unclassified engrams, the engrams which cannot be classified, the engrams out of which your dreams are made, your dream states are made, and out of which you paint this world, Actually, if there is little less karmashaya, you will straight away catch the master. Karmashaya is responsible for you not completely surrendering to master. Unfortunately, the karmashaya is such it operates on your inner space whenever you are not aware. When you are aware, it does not operate. Awareness is like a stay order for the karmashaya. When you are not aware, it goes on operating. So if you stay more time in awareness, the unoperated karmashaya naturally loses its power over you. Unoperated karmashaya means just you know this flavor, this odor is from godown. It is from godown. The moment you know it is from godown, the odor does not have any more influence, power over you. So the solution for the problem of karmashaya is be aware from morning till night. You move your first movement from bed to your last movement in bed. Be aware. Let's enter into the next sutra. Thirteenth sutra. In the second chapter, Satimule Tatvipaka Jati Ayubogaha. Swami Sachidananda translates this sutra as, with the existence of the root, there will be fruits also, namely, the births of the different species of life, their lifespans and experiences. Swami Vivekananda translates as, the root being there, the fruition comes in the form of species, longevity and experience of pleasure and pain. Prabhavananda translates as, so long as the cause exists, it will bear fruits such as rebirth, a long or a short life, and the experiences of pleasure and pain. As long as little bit of smell or the objects which causes the smell is left in your godown, there will be smell either intensely or very mildly. There will be disturbance in the form of birth, longevity and so many other things. Understand, through this sutra, Patanjali insists, emphasizes the importance of burning away all the engraved memories, samskaras. He insists burning away of all the memories. As long as there is a little bit left, even if little bit. See, loan, fire, enmity and samskaras should not be left even little bit. Should not be left even little bit. If you leave the loan little bit, interest to interest, it will be standing as a demon in front of you. Same way fire, if you think, oh, it's little, let's leave it. No, it'll grow and stand. Same way enmity, Even if you think it's little, let us leave it. No, it will grow and stand. Same way, samskaras, engraved memories. If you think, oh, it's little, no, it will grow and stand. I have a small story for you all. Woman at the party says to her friend, "See that handsome guy over there? He has been irritating me all the evening. All evening." The friend says, "Hey, how can it be? He is not even looking at you." She says, "I know, that is what is irritating me." As long as the other person is there, whether he looks at you or not, he is going to irritate you. As long as there is engram, whether it is going to directly happen, express itself as an action or not, it is going to irritate you. The odor of engram, the smell of engram, by itself will be the constant source of torture and irritation and suffering. Understand? Even if your joy is experienced because of your engram, it will not be a joy. It will not be a joy. For example, if you have an engram, that sweet is sweet brings joy to you. Put the sweets in your mouth continuously. Maybe 3 or 4 or at the most 10. After that? No, nothing more. Anything engram based is suffering. Understand? Even if you are pleasure, if it is measured with the scale of engram, it is suffering. It never leads you to pleasure. Pleasure means where the excitement happens for no reason, just because of overflowing energy, bubbling energy. You know you are joyful, but you don't know why. The moment you know why, you will spoil it. Because you are very intelligent. You are see, one of the biggest efficiencies you have is any great pleasure, you can destroy it. Are God gave you the enlightenment, you destroyed it. It's not that he did not give enlightenment, he took away the enlightenment from you. No. The other day, it seems one of my brahmachari was complaining to other person. Swamiji brought me here. Swamiji did everything, but I am really angry with him. Why is he not giving me enlightenment? All right, this fool should be very clear. Either he should think, I am responsible for everything. Or he should think, he is responsible for everything. If he thinks he is responsible for everything, then he should work for enlightenment. Or if he thinks I am responsible for everything, he should know, he brought me, he did everything, he is doing everything. So let him do, relax. That itself is enlightenment. That relaxation itself is enlightenment. This guy, all the bad things, he puts responsibility on me. And all the good things, he takes the responsibility. What to do? I am being used as a dustbin. That is a big problem. So understand, either he should take everything, all responsibilities is, I came, I am here, then I have to practice for enlightenment. Or he should know, no, Swamiji brought me here, Swamiji is doing everything, then let him do. No, he should do, but as I want. That is where the calamity starts. That is where the difficulty starts. If he is intelligent enough to pick me somewhere and bring me all the way, no, it is not intelligence, it's because of compassion. Sometime people are brought here to serve the sangha. Sometimes people are brought here, they can't be allowed in the society. There are two reasons why people are brought. Some people are brought, let them serve the society. Some people are brought, no, let us save the society. So if he has so much compassion to pick you up and bring you all the way and keep you here, he knows when to give enlightenment. That relaxation itself will be an enlightenment. But the human mind plays all possible games. Patanjali insists in the sutra the importance of destroying all the samskaras. Understand? Removing the samskaras has two level. One, if you reduce them to the thought level by removing attachments, your life will be great. You will have ecstatic life. But if you destroy them completely, you have the freedom not to have one more birth. I know human beings took birth just because of only 1 engram to have a cup of ice cream. That's all. Nothing else. The poor fellow, when he was about to leave the body, everything was lost. Just one desire, one slide, like not even desire, slide. When he had a cup of ice cream, he had a very sweet mood. That one slide, that fellow has to come and take one more birth. I've really seen. After I came out of prison, one small child was brought. And I asked that baby, what do you want? Child said, no, I want candy. I gave the candy. When I gave the candy, I saw, oh God, this fellow has taken birth just because of only one desire of candy. Nothing else. But oh God, what a waste of life. See, to create a human body, you need so much of engrams, and you need to make the hand, then body, then legs, head, little brain, if you need to do some work, and one heart, lungs, liver, kidney. So much this guy was preparing, creating in his mother's womb and assuming that body just for candy. I thought, oh God, what a great thing, because that guy fortunately has that desire to me. The moment I put the candy, I saw that slide just collapsing, just disintegrating. I know the child will become enlightened before 14. Before he physically gets matured. See, when you physically become matured, not only your sensory pleasure, your touch becomes new and alive, all your 5 senses becomes new and alive. That is why your taste of listening, taste of tongue, taste of smell, taste of seeing, everything takes a big shift the moment you are physically matured. So I saw this guy did not have any desire. Desire of sex, desire of smell, desire of listening, desire of seeing, nothing. Only that candy. Nothing else. So when that slide collapsed, that was the only slide based on which he built the whole body. That was his karmashaya. So when that collapsed, I know for sure, he will not even get physically matured. Means in ordinary way, he will be a paramahamsa. He'll just be a paramahamsa. Karmashaya. The importance of destroying all the engrams without leaving even one or two, so that you will have a complete freedom not to have one more life. The videha mukti happens. Actually, while you are alive, if you have diluted all the engrams into thoughts, when you leave the body, those thoughts will not be able to attract attention. They will just die down and you will become a videha mukta. But one important thing you need to know is, even if one engram is left, when you leave the body, you don't take care of that, even one engram can create the whole cycle of life. Whole cycle of life. Human beings. You could see how that slide collapsed in the child's inner space. That is what Manikyavasagar, a great enlightened master, he describes in one of his verses, Piranda Piraparukum Engal Peruman. Means, after taking birth, the cause of the birth can be just destroyed by his own touch. Piranda Piraparukum Engal Peruman. But don't expect you can once more come back just for that candy and ask me the candy and get liberated. Unfortunately for this child, I am here and that guy is here and candy is the only thing he asked and all the three matched. So it happened. But how do you know all three will match again once more for you? First of all, what is your engram which you want to leave? Nobody knows. And will you be able to meet the master? Nobody knows. And the third thing, will master be able to deliver you so easily? If you have some foolish engrams, what to do? For example, you have an engram to kill somebody. Master cannot just say, come on, bring that person, please kill it. No. It cannot happen. So better not to leave any engraved memory. When you leave the body, understand the key word from this sutra. The key word of this sutra is Satimule, means because of the root of the engrams exists. It leads to life, longevity, and all the sensory pleasures. If you reduce all the engrams into thoughts, your life will be happy. It's a life solution. But if you destroy all the engrams, you'll have the freedom not to take birth. That is what is sacred part. See, many times people ask me, Swamiji, you talk everything about life and life solution. Why do you make sannyasis? Why do you make people renounce life? Understand? I have two work. One, reducing all the engrams into thought. That is what is my job with the public, with all the devotees, disciples around the world. That is why I am so useful directly in their life. That is why I am so popular. Because directly I am useful. Who comes to me because I am a Swami? Nobody. Nobody. From the beginning people came to me because I am a utility. I have directly some use for them in their life. That is what is more like a life solution part. But there is a second part, sacred part, important part, destroying all engrams, which Patanjali describes in this sutra. This is what I am doing with my sannyasis. Understand? What Patanjali describes in the previous sutra, I am doing with common public, means reducing all the engrams into thoughts by removing attachments so that they can live a happy life, joyful life. But the second part, even the thoughts should not be allowed. That is what is sacred part. That sacred part needs many practices which common man will not be able to understand. That is why you need a monastery. Means a place where those practices are done. Where those practices are lifestyle. Where those practices are sacred. Where those practices can be experienced, enjoyed, without being judged. If you see honestly, a devotee who is outside, if he gets my teachings, immediately will see his whole life becomes colorful, ecstatic, great, joyful. But for my sannyasis, I don't show that joy. For them, I give a different space, different experience, because these guys are supposed to know even if one engram is left, for them anything is okay. If you can just put a little room cleaner, room freshener, that's enough. That's more like a room freshener. This is more like a completely cleaning the godown. Even if you need a tsunami or an earthquake or a forest fire, it has to be done because the godown has to be cleaned. So the two different jobs. Only the people whose godown is completely clean can put room freshener for others and help them to stay with their odor and adjust, reduce the power of the odor on them. There is a big difference. Devotees and disciples may need to levitate, but these guys need to keep the ground for them to land. So the job is totally different. And the purpose is totally different. And the life is totally different. So understand. Satimule, that's a keyword. Because root is there. Again and again and again, birth happens. Longevity happens. Worldly pleasures happens. What is the solution then? Just finish it, that's all. Simple decision to finish it. Simple decision not to allow the root to become tree, the root to sprout. You can do it. I'll see now, all of you experience a space suddenly where you, that your awareness is not getting converted into thoughts, just sealed. The clay is there, but you are not able to make any form out of that clay. See, the chit is clay. That you, awareness, you is clay. And any name or form made out of that is matter, is engram, fat. Now you will see, you is not getting converted into thought or engram. Just simple conscious decision. Let me be as my root. Let me not sprout as thought. Let me not grow as thought. Just be, that's all.
Bless you all. Let you all open all your three eyes and manifest the powers of Mahasadashiva.
Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Shivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om 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 Nityananda Paramashivoham. Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om 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 Nityananda Paramashivoham. Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om 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 Nityananda Paramashivoham. Yeah. शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम्
After a beautiful, powerful satsang on you to realize your Paramashiva and for you to come out of all your incompletions and go beyond pain, pleasure, emotions. It was just so amazing, and every line that Swamiji was saying was literally like clicking into your being. I'm sure all of you must have enjoyed this satsang. All you need to do is to apply these truths in your life today and share your experience on all social media platforms and enrich the world with the clicks that you are getting. And I would like all of you to also visit minutesforpeace.org website and spread this science knowledge behind real peace, that is bliss, to the entire universe. So without any further delay, we will be moving on to the Uttamottama Seva now. Thank you, Nityananda. As a part of this Uttamottama Seva, on this auspicious day of Bhavanavasara, Sunday, we will be offering Archana to Lord Kalabhairava, the most ferocious and compassionate form of Paramashiva. Connecting to this form of Paramashiva, just with intense bhakti towards him, all your obstacles, incompletions can become redundant and you will experience instant completion. Kalabhairava is a literal representation of ferocious decision for completion. Therefore, who is listening and watching this Uttamottama Seva, I would request all of you to just visualize Kalabhairava and establish a deep connection. We will be chanting 108 names of Lord Kalabhairava, and as each name is chanted, we will be offering a flower at the feet of Lord Kalabhairava. As we enjoy Lord Kalabhairava in these multiple dimensions, forms, multiple leelas, which are the divine place, we will be offering our gratitude out of deepest surrender to Lord Kalabhairava in the form of His Divine Holiness, Bhagwan Sri Nityananda Parameshwar. श्री कालभैरवा अष्टोत्तर शतनामावली ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज अर्चना एज ईच नेम ऑफ लॉर्ड कालभैरवा इज चांटेड द एनर्जी द वाइब्रेशंस फ्रॉम दैट एंटर्स इनटू योर सिस्टम डायरेक्टली एंड क्रिएट्स पावरफुल transformations and increases the frequency of your system. Swamiji often says that the more you relate to the deities and the more you're into temple rituals, the more will you manifest powers, as this is a time when you can directly connect to the ultimate, the formless in form in front of you, directly relate to him as Lord Kalabhairava himself. भैरवाय नमः ओम भूतनाथाय नमः ओम भूतात्मने नमः ओम भूतभावनाय नमः ओम क्षेत्रज्ञाय नमः ओम क्षेत्रपालाय नमः ओम क्षेत्रदाय नमः ओम क्षेत्रियाय नमः ओम विराजी नमः ओम क्षमाशानवासिने नमः ओम मामासाशिने नमः ओम कर्वराशिने नमः ओम स्मरात्मकाय नमः ओम रक्तपाय नमः ओम पानपाय नमः ओम सिद्धाय नमः ओम सिद्धाय नमः ओम सिद्धि सेविताय नमः ओम कमकालाय नमः ओम कालाशामनाय नमः ओम कलाकाष्ठाय नमः ओम तनये नमः ओम कवये नमः ओम त्रिनेत्राय नमः ओम बहुनेत्राय नमः ओम पिंगललोचनाय नमः ओम शूलपाणये नमः ओम खंगपाणये नमः ओम कपालिने नमः ओम धूम्रलोचनाय नमः ओम अभिरेव नमः ओम भैरवीनाथाय नमः ओम भूतपाय नमः ओम योगिनी पतये नमः ओम धनदाय नमः ओम धनहारिने नमः ओम धनवते नमः ओम प्रीतिवरदानाय नमः ओम नागहाराय नमः ओम नागपाशाय नमः ओम व्योमकेशाय नमः ओम कपालभृते नमः ओम कालाय नमः ओम कपामालिने नमः ओम कमनीयाय नमः ओम कलानिधये नमः ओम त्रिलोचनाय नमः ओम ज्वलन्नेत्राय नमः ओम त्रिशिखिने नमः ओम त्रिलोक कर्कशाय नमः, ओम त्रिनेत्रयतनायाय नमः, ओम दिम्भाय नमः, ओम शांताय नमः, ओम शांतजनप्रियाय नमः, ओम बटुकाय नमः, ओम बटुवेशाय नमः, ओम खट्वांगधारकाय नमः, ओम धनाध्यक्षाय नमः, ओम पशुपतये नमः, ओम भिक्षुकाय नमः, ओम परिचारकाय नमः, ओम धूर्ताय नमः, ओम दिगंबराय नमः, ओम शूराय नमः, ओम हरिने नमः, ओम पांडुलोचनाय नमः, ओम प्रशांताय नमः, ओम शांतिदाय नमः, ओम सिद्धाय नमः, ओम शंकर प्रिय बंधवाय नमः, ओम अष्टभूतये नमः, ओम निधीशाय नमः, ओम ज्ञानचक्षुषे नमः, ओम तपोमयाय नमः, ओम अष्टाधाराय नमः, ओम षडाधाराय नमः, ओम सर्पयुक्ताय नमः, ओम शिखिसखाय नमः, ओम भूधराय नमः, ओम बुधराधीशाय नमः, ओम भूपतये नमः, ओम भूधरात्मजाय नमः, ओम कंकालधारिने नमः, ओम मुंडिने नमः, ओम नागयज्ञोपवीतवते नमः, ओम जृंभनाय नमः, ओम मोहनाय नमः, ओम स्तंभिने नमः, ओम मरणाय नमः, ओम क्षोभनाय नमः, ओम शुद्धनीलांजनप्रख्याय नमः, ओम दैत्यघ्ने नमः, ओम मुंडभूषिताय नमः, ओम बलिभुजाय नमः, ओम बलिभूतनाथाय नमः, ओम बालाय नमः, ओम बालपराक्रमाय नमः, ओम सर्वापितारणाय नमः, ओम दुर्गाय नमः, ओम दुष्टभूतनिषेविताय नमः, ओम कामिने नमः, ओम कलानिधये नमः, ओम कांताय नमः, ओम कामिनी वशक कृद्वंशिने नमः, ओम सर्वसिद्धिप्रदाय नमः, ओम वैद्याय नमः, ओम प्रभवे नमः, ओम विष्णवे नमः। ओम श्री कालभैरव स्वामिने नमो नमः। नाना विध परिमल पत्र पुष्पाणि समर्पयामि। अथ धूपः। ओम धूरसि धूर धूर्वन्तं धूर्वतयो अस्मान् धूर्वदितं धूर्वयं वयं धूर्वामस्तं देवानां सस्सितमं पप्रतमं जुष्टतमं वह्नितमं देवहूतममतम सर्वदानं दृगुम समाह्वा मित्रस्य त्वाचक्षुषा प्रेक्षेमाभिर्मा संवित्ता मात्वा हिगुं दिशुं। ॐ श्री कालभैरव स्वामिने नमो नमः। धूपमाघ्रापयामि। अथ दीपः। ओम मुदीप्य स्वजात वेदो पग्निरृतिम मम पशुगुश्च मह्यमावह जीवनम च दिशो दिशा मानो हिगुंसी जात वेदो गामश्वंबुरुषं जगते अभिभ्रदग्नागैश्रिया मा परिपातय। ओम श्री कालभैरव स्वामिने नमो नमः। दीपं दर्शयामि।
अथ नैवेद्यम् ओम मधुवाता रतायते मधुक्षरन्ति सिंधवः माद्वीर्ण संतोषतीः मधुनक्त मतोषति मधुवत्पाति वगुम्रयः मधुद्योरसनः पिता मधुमान्नो वनस्पतिर् मधुवागुम्मस्तु सूर्यः माद्वीर्गावो भवन्तु नः मधु 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 ओम श्री कालभैरव स्वामिने नमो नमः निवेद्यं निवेदयामि। कर्पूर निराजनम् ओम कालकालाय विद्महे कालातीताय धीमहि तन्नो काल भैरव प्रचोदयात्। ओम कालकालाय विद्महे कालातीताय धीमहि तन्नो काल भैरव प्रचोदयात्। ओम कालकालाय विद्महे कालातीताय धीमहि तन्नो काल भैरव प्रचोदयात्। ओम श्री काल भैरव स्वामिने नमो नमः। कर्पूर निराजनम् संदर्शयामि रक्षां धारयामि।
Yeah. सर्वस्य सिद्धैः सर्वमेव तेन आत्मति सर्वं जयति ॐ ईशानः सर्वविज्ञानाम् ईश्वरः सर्वभूतानां ब्रह्माधिपतिर् ब्रह्मणोऽधिपतिर् ब्रह्मा शिवो मे अस्तु सदाशिवो श्रीनित्यानन्देश्वरि पराशक्तिसमेत श्रीनित्यानन्देश्वर परमशिवाय नमः रथदीपं सन्दर्शयामि ॐ सद्यो जातं प्रवत्यामि सद्यो जाताय वै नमो नमः भवे भवे नाति भवे भवस्वमान् भवोद्भवाय नमः ॐ वामदेवाय नमो ज्येष्ठाय नमः श्रेष्ठाय नमो रुद्राय नमो कालाय नमो कलविकरणाय नमो फलविकरणाय नमो फलाय नमो बलप्रमथनाय नमो सर्वभूततमनाय नमो मनोन्मनाय नमः ओम अघोरे एभ्यो तगोरे एभ्यो गोरेभ्यः सर्वे एभ्य सर्व सर्वे एभ्यो नमस्ते अस्तु रुद्र रूपेयः ओम पुरुषाय विद्महे महादेवाय धीमहि तन्नो रुद्र प्रचोदयात् ओम ईशान सर्व विज्ञानां ईश्वर सर्वभूतानां ब्रह्माधिपतिर् ब्रह्मनोधिपतिर् ब्रह्मा शिवो मे अस्तु सदाशिवो ओं नमो भगवते रुद्राय ओं नमस्ते रुद्रमन्यव उदोत ईशवे नमः नमस्ते अस्तु धन्वने बाहुभ्यामुदते नमः यात ईशुशिवतमा शिवं बभूवते धनुः शिवा शरव्यायात वटया नो रुद्रमृडया याते रुद्र शिवा तनोरघोरा पापकाशिनी तया नस्तनुवा शन्तमया गिरिशन्ता विचाकशी यामिशुं गिरिशन्तहस्ते बिभर्ष्यस्तवे शिवाङ्गिरित्रतां कुरु माहिगुंशी पुरुषं जगत् शिवेन वचसा त्वा गिरिशाच्च वदामसि यथा नः सर्वमिज्जगदयक्ष्मगं सुमना अशरम् अत्यवोचतदिवक्ता प्रथमो दैव्योऽभिषक् अहीगिश्च सर्वाञ्जम्बयन् सर्वाश्रयातु धान्यः असौ यस्ताम्रो अरुणौ तव पृश्युमङ्गलः एच्छेमागुं रुद्रा अभितो दक्षिश्रिता सहस्रशो वै सागुं हेन ईमहे अजव्यो वसर्पति नीलग्रीवो विलोहितः उतैनं गोपा अदृशन्नदृशन्नदहार्यः उतैनं विश्वाभूतानि सदृष्टो मृडयादिनः नमो अस्तु नीलग्रीवाय सहस्राक्षाय मीडुषे अतो ये अस्य चत्वानो हन्तेभ्यो करन्नमः प्रमुञ्च धन्वनस्त्वमुभयोराग्नियोर्ज्यां याश्च देहस्त इषव परागवो वप अवतत्य तनुत्वं सहस्राक्षिजतेषु ते निशील्यशल्यानामुखा शिवो न सुमना भव विद्यन्तनुकपर्दिनो विशल्यो भानवागुम् उद अनेशन्नश्येषव आपुरस्य निषङ्गतिः याते हेतिर्मीडुस्तमहस्ते बभूवते तनुः तयास्मान् विश्वतस्त्वमयक्ष्मया परिभुजा नमस्ते अस्त्वायुधाय नादताय कृष्णवे उभाभ्यामुतते नमो बाहुभ्यां तव धन्वने परिते धन्वनो हेतिरस्मान्मृणत्तु विश्वतः अतो य इषुतिष्ठवारे अस्मन्निदेहितम् ॐ नमस्ते अस्तु भगवन् विश्वेश्वराय महादेवायत्रयम्बकाय त्रिपुरान्धकाय त्रिकाग्निकालाय काल निरुद्राय नीलकण्ठाय नित्यानन्दाय मृत्युञ्जयाय सर्वेश्वराय सदाशिवाय श्रीमन्महादेवाय नमः श्रीनित्यानन्देश्वरि पराशक्तिदमेत श्रीनित्यानन्देश्वर परमशिवाय नमः कर्पूरनीराजनं सन्दर्शयामि
The next offering of Dhotamottama Seva is the offering of Chaturvedam.
Devadevottama Devata Sarvabhuma Akilanda Kodi Brahmanda Nayaka Shri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Shri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva Chaturveda Priya Chaturvedam Avadharaya Om Agnimede Purohitam Yajnasya Devam Ritvijam Hota Aram Ratnadhatamam Hari Om Hari Om Isheto Jetva Vayavasto Spayavastasya Devo Vasya Vita Prarpayato Jeshtatamaya Karmani Hari Om Hari Om Agna Ayahi Vitaye Grinano Havyatataye Nihotcha Chachi Parijishi Hari Om Hari Om Shanno Devi Rabishtaya Apo Pavantu Bijaye Shanyo Rabishtavantu Naha Hari Om Deva Devottava Deva Dasarva Bhuma Akilanda Kodi Brahmanda Nayaka Shri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Shri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva Agamashloka Priyagamashloka Navadharigat Shri Bhagavanu Vacha Adhikautuhala Vishta Prischasheta Shrunu Priye Yanmene Trantare Vakhner Yadvamritamanuttamam Tatsarvam Kathayishyami Yoga Yutya Shrunu Priye Yatvarupam Idam Shuddham Vyapakam Sarvatomukam Deva Devottama Devata Sarvabhuma Akilanda Kodi Brahmanda Nayaka Shri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Shri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva Stotra Priya Stotram Avadharaya Shrikanta Druginopamanyutapana Skandendra Natyadayaha Prachina Puravopiyasya Karuna Deshagadad Gauravam Tam Sarvadi Gurum Manogya Vapusham Mandasmita Alankritam Chinmudrankita Mudrapari Narinam Chitte Shivam Gurmahe Dusvapna Dusya Gunadargati Dadarmanasya Darbiccha Darvyasana Dusaha Duryashamshi Utpata Tapa Vishabiti Masadgrahati Vyagim Shanashayatume Jagatamadishaha Om Namo Bhagavate Sadashivaya Sakala Tattvatmakaya Sarva Mantra Swarupaya Sarva Yantra Dishtitaya Sarva Tantra Swarupaya Sarva Tattva Vidhuraya Brahma Rudra Avatarini Neelakantaya Parvati Manoharaya Soma Surya Agni Lochanaya Basmo Dhulita Vigrahaya Mahamani Makudadharanaya Manikya Bhushanaya Shustisthiti Pralayakala Raudhravataraya Dakshadvaradvamshakaya Mahakala Bhedanaya Mooladharaikanilagaya Tattvatitaya Gangadharaya Sarvadevadhitevaya Shadashrayaya Sakalavedantasaraya Trivargasadhanaya Ananta Kodi Brahmanda Nayakaya Ananta Vasukitakshakakar Kotakashanka Gulika Padma Mahapadme Dhyashta Mahanaha Kulabhushanaya Pranavasvarupaya Chidakashaya Akashadikshvarupaya Grahanakshatravalune Sakalaya Kalankarahitaya Sakalalokaika Katre Sakalalokaika Bhartre Sakalalokaika Hartre Sakalalokaika Gurave Sakalalokaika Kaikasakshine, Sakala Nigamaguhyaya, Sakala Vedanta Paragaya, Sakala Lokaika Varapradaya, Sakala Lokaika Shankaraya, Shashanka Shekharaya, Shashvata Nijavasaya, Nirabhasaya, Niramayaya, Nirmalaya, Nirlobhaya, Nirmadaya, Nishchintaya, Nirahankaraya, Nirankushaya, Nishkalankaya, Nirgunaya, Nishkamaya, Nirupaplavaya, Niravadhyaya, Nirantaraya, Nishkaranaya, Nirantakaya, Nishprapanchaya, Nishyangaya, Nirdvandvaya, Niradharaya, Niragaya, Nishkrodhaya, Nirbalaya, Nishpapaya, Nirbhayaya, Nirvikalpaya, Nirbhedaya, Nishkriyaya, Nistulaya, Nishamshayaya, Niranjanaya, निरुपमभिभवाय नित्य शुद्ध बुद्ध परिपूर्ण सच्चिदानन्दाद्वयाय परमशान्तस्वरूपाय तेजो रूपाय तेजोमयाय जय जय रुद्र महारौद्र भद्रावतार महाभैरव कालभैरव कल्पान्तभैरव कपालमालाधर खड्वांग खड्ग चर्म पाशांकुश डमरूशूल चाप भान गद शक्ति भिंदिपाल तोमर मुसल मुद्गर पाश परिग भुशुंडी शतग्नि चक्राद्यायुत भीषणकर सहस्रमुखदंश्राकर लवधन विकटाट्टहास निष्पारित ब्रह्मांडमंडल नागेन्द्रकुंडल नागेन्द्रहार नागेन्द्रवलय नागेन्द्रचर्मधर मृत्युंजय त्रयंबक त्रिपुरांतक विश्वरूप विरूपाक्ष विश्वेश्वर वृषभवाहन विश्वतोमुख सर्वतो रक्ष रक्षमा ज्वल ज्वल महामृत्युम् अपमृत्युभयं नाशय नाशय चोरभयं उच्छादय उच्छादय विषसर्पभयं शमय शमय चोरान् मारय मारय मम शत्रून् उच्छादय उच्छादय त्रिशूलेन विधारय विधारय कुठारेण भिन्दि भिन्दि खड्गेन चिन्दि चिन्दि कट्वाङ्गेन विपोतय विपोतय मुसलेन निष्पेशय निष्पेशय बाणी सन्तारय सन्तारय रक्षांशी भीषय भीषय अशेषभूतानि विद्रावय विद्रावय कुष्पाण्ड वेताल मारीच ब्रह्मराक्षसगणान् संत्राशय संत्राशय माम् अभयं कुरु कुरु मित्रस्तं माम् आश्वाशय आश्वाशय नरकभय महाभयान् माम् उद्धर उद्धर संजीवय संजीवय क्षत्रभ्यां माम् आप्यायय आप्यायय दुःखादरं माम् आनन्दय आनन्दय शिवकवचे नमाम् आच्छादय आच्छादय मृत्युंजय त्र्यंबक सदाशिव नमस्ते नमस्ते। देवदेवोत्तम देवता सार्वभौम अखिलांड कोटि ब्रह्मांड नायक श्री नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानंदेश्वर परम शिव द्राविड वेद प्रिय द्राविड वेदम अवधारिका शिवात्रचित्रम्भलं मन्दिरमावदनीर् वानवर्मेलदनीर् सुन्दरमावदनीर् तुदिकपडवदनीर् तन्दिरमावदनीर् समयतुल्लदनीर् सिन्धुवर्मामुमैपङ्गन् तिर आलवायन्तिरनीर् आलवायन्तिरनीर् तिर आलवायं तिरुनीरे शिवा तिरुचित्रम्बलम्
The next offering is the offering of the Paramashiva Shakti Avishkarna at the feet of Devi Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Shri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva. Deva Devottama Devata Sarvabhoma Akhilanda Koti Brahmanda Nayaka Shri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Shri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva. Paramashiva Shakti Avishkarana Priya Paramashiva Shakti Avishkarana Mavadharaya.
Paramashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham Shivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham Nityananda Paramashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham
Nityanandam Paramasukadam Kevalam Jnanamurtim Dvandvatitam Gagana Sadrisham Tattvamasyadilakshyam Ekam Nityam Vimalamachalam Sarvadi Sakshibhutam Bhavatitam Trigunarahitam Sadgurum Tam Namami
Nityanandam, I welcome all the visitors, viewers, Kailayavasis from all over the world, from various Kailasas, to this segment of today's Uttamottama Seva, the offering of Paramashiva Shakti Avishkarana. Just today, Swamiji revealed a very beautiful revelation and one of the greatest opportunities to be there as a deity next to Swamiji himself. In India, in the state Tamil Nadu, literally called as the city of Lord, Parameshwara himself is the land Madurai, and there in the main temple we've got the biggest opportunity by Swamiji to be there as a deity in that land. And this is literally like becoming part of Parameshwara himself. So this great opportunity is a very rare and a very powerful opportunity for all of you. So before directly entering into the Shakti or whatever, I would like to tell all of you that it is time you decide to become part of this amazing happening. So I would actually like to read out what exactly Swamiji had told and what exactly did he bless the humanity with. So Swamiji had posted just a few minutes back blessings to the first batch of devotees who are going to be deified in the spiritual epic center of the universe, the Kailasunada Dvadashanta Shyamala Pita Sarvajna Pitam.
And Swamiji puts a huge post, I mean a really, really long post, and Swamiji was explaining about how you can be a part of this. So Swamiji has explained about the story of Meenakshi, how in the land of Madurai, the king, Maledhvaja, wanted a child, and he did intense tapas for it. And Lord Meenakshi herself, I mean Devi Parashakti herself, decided to land as Meenakshi, and she was born out of the fire, out of the very sacrificial fire which they are performing in order to get a child. Out of that, Devi herself emerged as Meenakshi, as the queen of all three worlds. She's also called Digvijaya because any direction she went, all the 10 directions she conquered and established completion, established the enlightened ecosystem. And now in that very spot where Devi Meenakshi had happened, all of you have the opportunity to become a deity there. Swamiji will specially bless each of you and inaugurate your deity in that area. So without any delay, I would like all of you to jump into this as soon as possible. And also all of you can go to Swamiji's Facebook page, Sri Nityananda Parameshwaram, and view that post. So today, what we are going to be doing, in order to make this desire happen as a reality for all of you, is scan you and find out what you need to do to become part of this Kailasonada Shyamala Peeta Sarvajna Peetam. How you can contribute, how you can clear all your obstacles and contribute for this happening. So if you want to do it right away, you can leave a comment below, and our Balasanth Manitya Swapremananda will be scanning you and finding out the problems, the obstacles, the blind spots, or whatever incompletions that is distracting you and stopping you from making this into your reality. So as we are waiting for our visitors to leave a comment, I'll be reading out the Shastra Pramana and explaining the scriptural reference to this Shakti of mind reading.
The Shastra Pramana for the power of advanced mind reading is from the Vijnana Bhairava Tantra, Sutra 51, Dharana 28. The Pramana goes as
Yatha tatha yatra tatra dvadasham te manakshipet pratikshanam kshina vritter vailakshanyam diner bhavet yatha tatha yatra tatra द्वादशां ते मनः क्षिपेत् प्रतिक्षणं क्षीणवृत्तेर् वैलक्षण्यं दिनेर्भवेत् यथा तथा यत्र तत्र द्वादशां ते मनः क्षिपेत् प्रतिक्षणं क्षीणवृत्तेर् वैलक्षण्यं दिनेर्भवेत्.
The translation of this verse goes as: whenever one fixes and centers the mind and inner space at any place at the Dvadashamta, the energy center between the eyebrows at the third eye, at every moment in continuity, howsoever and wherever one may be, during any action, walking, talking, resting, etc., the fluctuation and modifications of the mind will diminish and cast away completely, and within days or within moments, he will experience extraordinary states of the powers of Bhairava.
So as it is heard from Parameshwar himself, that when you experience that oneness, you can express extraordinary shaktis. Now, Master Prema will be entering into that same space of oneness by chanting the Mahavakya, and will be expressing the shakti of mind reading, where she will scan and find out what you need to do to become part of this Kailasonada Shyamala Pita, the Sarvajna Pita. So we have Ma Jamie Love, who has commented saying, "I want to scan, please." So now Ma Jamie will be scanning you. I request you to sit with your head, neck and spine in a straight line and get into a deep space of listening. Visualize in your third eye that you are going to stand as a deity in the temple of Devi Meenakshi herself.
Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. 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 Om Nityananda Paramashivoham.
Ma Jamie, what I saw about your patterns is that you can easily break them. It's just you that you need just one decision. Whatever you want to manifest in your life, like this offer that Swamiji has made to us, you just need to sit, make a conscious decision about yourself and contemplate on it. Think about it deeply. The only thing you need to do is make a conscious decision that you will achieve this opportunity and place a deity of yourself in that temple.
So it's actually very easy for him. It's literally just your decision, Ma. Actually, when I could see the same. So whoever is watching this currently, whoever is listening to this, I would request all of you to do this right away. Please sit with your head, neck and spine in a straight line. Close your eyes. And visualize yourself as a deity next to that of His Divine Holiness, Bhagwan Sri Nityananda Parameshwar. Visualize through your third eye that you will manifest and become part of this greatest blessing ever, which is to become a deity in the temple of Lord Meenakshi herself. Chant Mahavakya internally, intensely. Whatever thoughts, cognition, obstacles may come up to stop you, with your will persistence, just decide, if I want it, I will make it happen. Actually, all of us have this will persistence. That's why as a child, if you've realized, if you might remember,
any time in our childhood, we always tend to throw tantrum and somehow get what we want. Whether it is a candy or a toy car or, you know, want your mom next to you. We somehow throw all kind of tantrum, do all dramas and get it happen. Like, we somehow make it happen. That will persistence is actually still there in each and every one of us. It's just our decision to focus and ferociously use that will persistence to make what you want happen. So, Ma Swaprima, would you like to share something about this will persistence and how you can use this in your life?
Will persistence. When you want to achieve something in your life, you feel like you're not capable. You might not be able to achieve it. But what Swamiji says is, when you move all your incompletions, all your thoughts aside, the only thing left is will persistence. When you become so ferocious to make what you want happen, it happens. The whole cosmos brings it in line for you. So just chant the Mahavakya and make your will persistence come and work. It will happen for you.
Yes, actually, that is how even prayer manifestation happens. All the Balasins in the Nitya and the Gurukul continuously put our will persistence and just decide, Swamiji's truth, it will happen. And it happens. So the same way, now, when Swamiji has shared it, he is blessed for it. Actually, on many satsangs previously, Swamiji has told, when Guru ordains, he sustains. So when Swamiji is revealing this huge opportunity to all of you, that means he has already blessed it. Only with his blessings can you even hear about it. Only with his blessings can you even see the post. So whoever has now heard this or seen his post about this greatest opportunity, without any delay, decide to jump into it and make it happen right away. And if any of you have got any questions or any clarifications is required, you can personally message any of us Kailayavasis or any of us Balasins, or you can also leave a comment below this post. So thank you all for joining us today, and thank you, Ma Swaprima, for your beautiful scanning. With this, we offer our gratitude at the feet of Paramashiva and Parashakti in the form of His Divine Holiness, Bhagwan Sri Nityananda Paramashiva. Thank you, Nityananda.
Nityananda.
Om Nityananda Paramashivoham.
The next offering is the offering of Tirukailaya Vadya. Devadevottama Devata Sarvabhoma Akilanda Koti Brahmanda Nayaka Shri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Shri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva Tirukailaya Vadya Priya Tirukailaya Vadyam Avadaraya.
Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Nityananda Paramashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham नित्यानंद परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानंद परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानंद नित्यानंद परमशिवोऽहम्
Thank you. शिवा त्रैलोक्ये शुभकरा संध्या तांडव प्रिय पाहि मां भवभयहर शंभो शंकर शिवा त्रैलोक्ये शुभकरा संध्या तांडव प्रिय पाहि मां भवभयहर शंभो शंकर शिवा त्रैलोक्ये शुभकरा संध्या शंकर शिवा
Shiva.